Previous class we were discussing about congruency. Okay, this third one I will do it again. I'll explain it again to you. Now, what they have given the third one? They have given the two triangles. You need to show whether these are correct or not. What they have given, it's correct or not. Okay. Now see, they have given the markings. No, this single line, this is single line. What does that mean? BC equals EG. Okay. And here they have given double line. Here they have given double line. That means AC equals EF. And again, you have this one and this one. That is AB equals GF. Okay, so these are the three sides equal they have given, and then the angles also they have marked and given. Okay, so based on that, you have to show whether this is correct or not. So here you have angle A and angle G. Are they equal or not? They have asked. Okay, angle A and angle G, are they equal or not? They have asked. So where is your angle A? This is your angle A and this is your angle G. They are not equal, right? Because your two things are given, your only single thing is given. So this is not corresponding. Angle A and angle G are not corresponding. Similarly, angle B and angle E. This is your angle B and this is your angle E. It's a single marking. And here they are not given any marking at all. Okay. So they are also not corresponding. Angle B and angle G. Angle B and angle G. Okay. Angle B and angle G, they are corresponding. Then you have AC and GF. This is your AC, which is your AC here. This is your AC. And this is your GF. GF. AC, how many lines are given? Two markings are given. Here they have given three markings. So what we say, they are not equal. They are not corresponding. Next one is BA and FG. This is your BA and this is your FG. Okay, here three markings are given. Here also three markings are given. So these both are equal. They are corresponding. Last one you have. EF and BC. This is your EF. Where is your EF? This is your EF. EF two markings are given. BC how many markings are given? Only one marking. So these two are not corresponding. These two are not equal. Corresponding sides. Okay. These two are not the corresponding sides. They are not equal. So this completed your third one. This already we have done in the previous class. Now we will go for the fourth one. Now fourth one, what they have told? State whether the two triangles are congruent or not and justify your answer. Okay, we need to say based on what category these two triangles are congruent. That is by SSS, all the three sides are equal, or SAS, two sides and one angle is equal, or ASA, two angles and one side equal, or RHS, right angle hypotenuse side. Okay, that is used only for a right angle triangle. So we have to check which property is applicable in which figure. Okay. So congruency you have to see for two figures. Okay. Two triangles you have to see. Now the first triangle when you see properly. The first one, what they have given? They have given this side equals this side. They have not given a name and all. Okay. So this side equals this side. And this marking means what? This angle equals this angle. Okay. And what about this side? This side is common to this triangle as well as this triangle. Okay, again I am repeating what all things are given. See the figure. This side equals this side and this angle equals this angle. And what about this side, that blue color? This side is common to both the triangles. Okay, this side is common to both the triangles. So, you have to see by which congruency the two triangles are congruent. So, here you have your side. Okay, here you have the angle equal and here you have the common side. Again, you have the side here, you have the angle here, you have the side. So, see in the figure, you should make out which type of congruency is applicable. So, here you have side, angle, side. Here also you have side, angle, side. Okay, so we will start the sum. So, first what you do? First you name the triangle. Okay, so it will be easy for you to do. So here I have named the triangle ABC. You can give your own name. ABC. And here you have. This point is D. And these two sides are given equal. These two angles are also given equal. And this is AD is the common side. So in triangle ABD. This triangle, how will you name it? ABD. And second triangle is ADC. In these two triangles, AB equals AC. You can name it in any way. Okay, now. So, AB equals AC. That is given to you. Then, AD equals AD is the common side. And angle BAD equals angle CAD. That is also given to you. So what we can say, triangle ABD. See how I am naming it. Triangle. See, first when you are writing, you can write in any way. But when you are writing this congruency, you have to check the order and you have to write. Okay. Here you can write it in any order, but here be very careful when you are writing. So triangle ABD. This triangle ABD. This triangle is congruent to triangle ACD. ACD. Okay, triangle ABD is congruent to triangle ACD. Okay, this AD and this AD are the common side. They are equal. Then angle, this angle equals this angle. That also is correct only. Okay, that is how you have to write the order. ABD, ABD is congruent to triangle ACD. By which congruency rule? SAS. SAS congruency criterion, or we say SAS rule. Okay, now we will go for the next one. The second one is very easy. What they have given, see, here one marking. What does that mean? This side equals this side. Next thing, what they have given, here double marking, here double marking. So this side equals this side. And what about this side BC? BC is common to this triangle also. BC is congruent to down triangle also. BC is common to up triangle and the down triangle. Okay. This side BC is common to both the triangles. So in triangle ABC and triangle DCB. Okay. This triangle ABC and DCB. These two triangles, what you have? AB equals DC. Okay. AB equals DC. BD equals AC. Okay, BD equals AC. And then what about the side BC? BC equals BC, common side. Like this you have to write, okay? Whenever the common side is given, you have to write that side equals that same side. Reason is common side. Everywhere you have to write the reason, okay? Why this is equal, you have to write the reason. If it's given to you, or if it's an isosceles triangle also, the two sides will be equal, like that. Okay, whatever is given, reason you have to write that. So first thing is AB equals DC, that is given to you. AC equals BD, that is also given to you. BC equals BC, that is the common side. So we say the two triangles are congruent. By which congruency? SSS. Side, side, side. Here also you have SSS, that is side, side, side. So triangle ABC is congruent. This is the congruent symbol. Like this you do. And put two lines. Okay. So triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DCB by SSS rule. Okay. So this is how the second one is. Now the third one you have. See. This angle. They have given the two triangles. We have named it. ABC is the first triangle we have named. They have not given the name. Only for writing these things. Steps we are writing. We are naming the triangles. Okay. This is your ABC. This is your ECD. So here you have the first one. What they have given? This angle A equals angle E. See the markings in the figure. Accordingly you have to write. Okay. How will you name this angle? Angle BAC equals angle CED. Okay. Angle BAC equals angle CED. That's the first thing given. Second thing, what they have marked, this side equals this side, that is AC equals CE. Okay, AC equals CE. This is the second thing given. And what about this angle and this angle? These two angles are what type of angles? They are vertically opposite angles. Okay, they are vertically opposite angles. How will you name this angle? Angle ACB equals angle DCE. Okay, these two angles are vertically opposite angles. So, these angles also will be equal. Okay, so here you have, this is the angle, this is the side, this is the angle. Again, you have the angle, side, angle. Okay, so this is how you will say that the two triangles are congruent. So, we will write that in triangle ABC and triangle CDE. AC equals CE given. Okay, AC equals CE, that is given to you. Then angle BAC equals angle CED. This angle, okay. that is also given to you. And then these two angles are vertically opposite angles. Which angle? Angle ACB and angle ECD. Vertically opposite angles. Therefore, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle CED. See, by SASA rule. Okay. ABC. ABC is congruent to triangle BDC. Okay, this will come as angle A equals which angle? E. No, so this will be E and this B and D. Okay, E, D, C. Okay, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle ECDC. By which rule? ASA congruency rule or ASA rule. See, because angle A equals angle E, first E will come, okay? E, D, C. Angle, this C and C are common angles, no? Vertically opposite angles. So, this completes your third one. This was your third one, okay? This completes your third one. Now, next we will go for the fourth one. Now, fourth one, what they have given? Fourth one, they have given these triangles like this, okay? And here, they have given one symbol. What is the symbol? This is a 90 degree symbol. Okay, this angle W and this angle Z are right angles. They both are 90 degree. And what about this side and this side? They are equal. That is XW equals XZ. Okay, XW equals XZ. And what when you take these two triangles, what about the side XY? XY is the common side to both the triangles. Okay, XY is the common side to both the triangles. So, we will start in triangle XYZ and triangle XYW. What all things you have? Angle W equals angle Z. That is given to you. That is equals 90 degree. That is given to you. Okay. Now, whenever you have a right angle triangle, usually you will have which congruency? RHS. Okay. Think of RHS. That is right angle hypotenuse side. What do you mean by this word H hypotenuse? Hypotenuse means, as I told you, the side which is opposite to 90 degree. This is the 90 degree. This is the side which is opposite to 90 degree. That is RHS. Okay. So, here you have angle W equals angle Z equals 90 degree. Okay. The next thing you have is XW equals XZ. XW equals XZ, that also is given to you. And then XY equals XY. Okay, XY equals XY, common hypotenuse. HYPOTENUSE, common hypotenuse. So we say these two triangles are congruent by RHS congruency rule. Okay, these two triangles are congruent by RHS congruency rule. This completes your fourth one. So, angle W equals angle Z equals 90 degree given to you. XW equals XZ, that also is given to you. And what about XY? XY equals XY, common side or common hypotenuse. So, the two triangles are congruent by RHS rule. Okay. Now, the next one, that also very easy. Next one you have, see, next one they have not given the right angle symbol, okay. Though it looks like a rectangle, right angle, this two sides angles are right angles, but they have not given that. So, we can't assume it as a right angle, okay. So, here what they have given, see, when you take this triangle ABC and CDE, CDA, what are things they have given? AB equals CD, right? AB equals CD, that is one thing. And what about AD equals BC? And one more thing is, this is the common side of this triangle as well as this triangle. Both the triangles when you take, AC is the common side. Okay, so we will write in triangle ABC and triangle ADC. What are things you have? AD equals BC, that is given to you. Okay, AD equals BC given to you. Next thing is AB equals CD, that also is given to you. And then you have AC equals AC, the common side. So we say triangle ABC is congruent to triangle ADC by SSS rule. Okay, by SSS congruency rule, these two triangles are what? Congruent. Okay, these two triangles are congruent by SSS congruency rule. ABC and this will be BC and AD are equal, right? So BC and AD are equal, AB and CD are equal. Okay, AB and CD are equal. So this will be triangle ABC is congruent to triangle CDA by SSS rule. Okay, so these two things are congruent. So this completes your fifth one. So now what we will do, this fifth one over, that is your fourth Roman letter is over. Now in our next class, we will go for the fifth Roman letter.